Arrhythmias. Arrhythmia is a disturbance in the rhythmic contractions of the atria and ventricles due to disorders in impulse production or impulse conduction. The disorders in impulse production may result in arrhythmias like premature beats, non-sinus rhythms, tachycardias, bradycardias, fibrillation, and flutter. Disorders in impulse conduction may result in partial or complete heart block or AV block, right and left bundle branch blocks, WPW syndrome, and sinus pause with escape beats. Now we shall study these arrhythmias in details one by one. Premature beat is a beat arising from an ectopic focus outside the SA node and occurring before the next sinus beat. It may arise in the atria, AV node, or in the ventricles because pacemaker cells are located in the atria, AV node, bundle of His, and Purkinje fibers in the ventricles. In this strip, a premature beat has occurred after beat number 2. As a result, the expected sinus beat number 3 is missed, and after a small pause, the next sinus beat number 4 comes and the sinus rhythm starts again. The pause between the premature beat and the next sinus beat is termed as the compensatory pause, and it compensates for the early occurrence of the premature beat. If it compensates exactly for the missed beat, and the third sinus beat occurs exactly where it would otherwise have occurred, then it is termed as a complete compensatory pause. Observe this strip carefully. The red spots mark the expected occurrence of P waves, and the black line at the top marks the expected occurrence of the R waves, that is, if the sinus rhythm was undisturbed. You will note that the beat after the premature beat has occurred exactly where it should have occurred. So this is a complete compensatory pause. In contrast, in this tracing, the beat after the premature beat has occurred before the next expected beat. So this is incomplete compensatory pause. To study the compensatory pause, count each RR interval. The first normal RR interval is 20 small squares. The RR interval of the premature beat is 14 small squares. And the RR interval of the compensatory pause is 23 small squares. The two added together, 14 plus 23, is 37 small squares. Whereas it should have been exactly 2 times the normal RR interval of 20 small squares, that is 40 small squares. So this is an incomplete compensatory pause. Ventricular premature beats have a complete compensatory pause, as the impulse arising in the ventricles does not affect the rhythm of the SA node. In contrast, an impulse arising in the atrium will depolarize the SA node early, disturbing its rhythm, and hence the next impulse from the SA node will come earlier than the expected next beat. The premature beat always arises outside the SA node, so it is also termed as ectopic beat or extrasystole. It may arise anywhere in the heart, the common sites being atria, AV node, or ventricles. Depending on the site of origin, the premature beat is termed as supraventricular or ventricular. The atrial and nodal premature beats are termed as supraventricular premature beats. In these beats, the impulse will reach the ventricles via the normal conduction pathway. So the QRS complex on ECG will have a normal configuration. This is a nodal premature beat. But if the impulse arises below the division of bundle of His, in one of the bundle branches or in the ventricles, then both ventricles will not be activated at the same time, resulting in a wide, slurred and bizarre QRS complex with T wave directed opposite to the main QRS complex. It is grossly different from the normal beats. This is a ventricular premature beat. Compare it with the normal rate and note the wide QRS with inverted T wave. Once again, note the features of a ventricular premature beat. The QRS complex is wide and bizarre, and the T wave is opposite in direction to the main QRS complex. So let us now study the differences between ventricular and supraventricular or atrial premature beats. Number one, the atrial premature beat has normal QRS configuration, while ventricular premature beats have a wide and bizarre QRS complex. Number two, the atrial premature beats have incomplete compensatory pause, whereas ventricular premature beats have a complete compensatory pause. Number three, ventricular premature beats have no P wave. A preceding P wave is seen only in supraventricular premature beats, though it may not always be visible. It may be merged with the previous T wave. When QRS complex of the premature beat has normal configuration, the beat is supraventricular. Its site of origin can be determined by studying the P wave. In this premature beat, the P wave is similar but slightly different from the other sinus beats. This is an atrial premature beat. Note the upright P wave slightly altered in an atrial premature beat. The PR interval is normal. In this ECG, the premature beat shows an altered P wave different from the regular sinus P waves. So this is an atrial premature beat. This premature beat has an inverted P wave with a very short PR interval. This is a nodal premature beat. The P wave is inverted as the impulse travels in the reverse direction in the atrium. And the PR interval is short because the nodal delay in conduction is eliminated. Inverted P wave and short PR interval. In this ECG, note the upright P wave of the previous sinus beat and inverted P wave of the premature beat indicating nodal origin. This premature beat has no P wave. This is also a nodal premature beat. If the impulse arises in the lower part of the AV node, the P wave will be delayed and may occur with the QRS complex or even after the QRS complex. In this case, it has occurred with the QRS complex and hence it is not seen or absent.